Good evening, I'm Nicholas Hoare for Vermont PBS. Some years ago, a gentleman by the name of Philip Hook wrote a splendid inside view of the auction house Sotheby's, and it was called, an interesting play on words, Breakfast at Sotheby's. This book, which was met with instant acclaim in London, became quite well known in international circles to the extent that he's decided to write a sequel. And that book, which is less to do with Sotheby's and rather more to do with art businesses in general, is called Rogue's Gallery. And this is the subject of this evening's talk. Rogue's Gallery is the inside story on a succession of rogues and vagabonds who made up an extraordinary coterie of dealers in initially Antwerp and subsequently London and New York. Of course, it then spread like a disease, if I can call it that, all around the world, and the art business now is colossal. However, the origins of the art market are very interesting. And for those who have an interest in paintings in general and dealers in particular, you can do no better than to read this book. It's mischievous, it's rather tongue-in-cheek, but it's extremely accurate and very much to the point. It covers most of the dealers that we know today, household names like that roguish Sir Joseph Duveen, to the French dealer Paul Durand Ruelle, to all sorts of others, right down to today's Leo Castelli in New York. Fascinating insights. It tells you graphically what went on, and the gossip, which is both scurrilous and entertaining, is worth the price of admission alone. So I recommend this book highly for anybody who wishes to have the inside glimpse of the art business, written by a gentleman who was with Sotheby's for 40 unbroken years. Rogue's Gallery, A History of Art and Its Dealers, warmly recommended. And on that artistic note, good evening.